Let's get this derby started. King, who you got for us?
All right, let's bring out the Daughters of Doom. Starting with number 8, I'll See You Later. Number 21, Fright Town. Number 22, Elevator. 211, Grace Lightning. Number 62, American Gangster. Number 84, Ferocious. 917, Apple Smash. 828, Strawberry Short Fuse. 222, Gloom and Doom. 203, Special K Serial Killer. 52, Bee Stings. 38, Cthulhu. 11, Smash Tag. 444, Wheel Savage. And number 47, So Feisty. Let's get your hands together for the Daughters of Doom.
They're in red and black, and there's no skating back. It's the Voodoo Dolls. Number 10, A-Bomb. Number 112, Skull Crusher. Number 14, Screamsicle. Number 17, Little Trickster. Number 171, Sassafras. Number 2, Donut Mess With Me. Number 327, Scooby-Doom. Number 4, Glitter Bomb. Number 51, Crazy Train. Number 55, Electric Mayhem. Number 620, Patty Hurts. Number 626, Tantrum. Number 65, Dragon Slayer. And number 789, Unicorn. Give it up for the Voodoo Dolls. It might be a little blurry at first, but it's still super fun. And by the time the second half rolls around, you will have a handle on the facts. So first fact for you, the skaters lined up way in the back in front of that line called the jam line. They're called the jammers. They set themselves apart by wearing stars on their helmets.
It looks like it's gonna be L, See You Later. And I believe that's Donut Mess With Me. L, See You Later is out first, and she is your lead jammer.
Now, lead jammer is a very special jammer. Both jammers on the track are allowed to score points, but it's the lead jammer, Jumping Apexes on display by I'll See You Later, that has control of how long this jam will last. A jam will last no more than 2 minutes, but it can be shorter, as I'll See You Later so aptly demonstrated by tapping their hips, signaling to the referees that jam should be called off.
Yep, all the Jammers do is basically get out there, score a little points. From time to time, they do play some defense, but the stars on the helmet indicate that's your offense.
You make it sound so easy.
I know, right?
Maybe it's because they make it look so easy, but I assure you, it is not.
That's going to be Crazy Train out on the line, and also Ferocious.
Ferocious will earn that lead jammer status, and a track cut infraction is being assessed against Daughters of Doom skater Wheel Savage. Wheel Savage is a blocker. Blockers are the skaters on the track not wearing stars, and they are responsible for both helping their jammer earn points while at the same time trying to prevent the opposing team's jammer from scoring points.
Looks like Electric Mayhem on the line going up against American Gangsta. Well, in case you're wondering about all those other players, those are the blockers out there. Right now, two blockers for the Daughters of Doom are sitting in the penalty box.
And that blocker advantage was what Dragon Slayer needed. Dragon Slayer is out first, but not lead jammer. And because Dragon Slayer had already made it around on the initial pass, that last pass was a scoring pass. A jammer has to get through the opposing blockers one time through before being eligible to score points.
Wow, can I say that Dragon Slayer has really elevated her game since the last time we saw her.
Lots of Wheaties in the off season and burpees and protein shakes too.
I remember a few years ago she came out here and she was just nothing more than some skates and a helmet. Man, look at her now.
And was still leaping across apexes even then also.
Well, that's another 5 points put on the board. And with that, the Voodoo Dolls are on top.
Dragon Slayer is a great power jam out there. A power jam is what happens when one of the jammers is in the penalty box. Now it's going to be the Daughters of Doom's turn to take a shot at power jam as Dragon Slayer is currently in the Pabst Blue Ribbon penalty box.
Oh, she came in very hot. Looks like a forearm call. And as you can see, I know a lot of folks that we got some new rules. There is no point of no return on the track. So if you get a penalty, you can go directly to the penalty box from wherever you may be.
I'm sure that's really awesome for all the skaters on the track. Just one more level of awareness for the referees to be conscientious of.
Wow, there was a lot of action in that last jam as it comes to an end.
A lot of action and a lot of points as well. 14 put up in that just last jam. Voodoo Dolls taking the lead, 14-12.
That's right, there's 15 minutes left in this half. And as you don't, a lot of folks out there don't know, these halves are only 20 minutes for the rose petals. So that's why there's only 15 minutes left.
Every minute, do or die, Uniscorn. Off that line, unopposed. Last line of defense and out for lead jammer.
She just, excellent work on that outside low, and a cut is called. And so once again, there'll be a new power jam benefiting Armara Ken Gangster.
And just to let you know, this jam will go the full 2 minutes. When a lead jammer is sent to the penalty box, their lead jammer abilities are therefore forfeited. They are still capable of scoring points, of course, but that means that no one is capable of calling the jam short.
Right, and as you know in the game of roller derby, penalty is when you cut the track, if you step out of bounds and come in front of an opposing player or in front of multiple players on your own team, that's considered a cut. We'll see.
That is correct. It's really about not being able to take an advantage over the positioning of the person that knocked you out of bounds.
Well, that right there, Daughters of Doom Jammer came in extremely hot and ended up picking up a back block. A back block is when you block someone directly in the middle of their back, and that'll cause a penalty.
One of many danger zones, that is for sure. Very hard to harness your speed out here, especially when it's a little bit colder. Crash kaboom down the center. Uniscorn fights out that fierce wall of defense put up by the Daughters.
Well, right now, both teams lining up. A little bit of offense coming from the inside from the Voodoo Dolls. And this jam comes to an end, but not before another 3 points gets picked up. Mouth, what do you got?
Well, we would like to thank Tonkin.com. The largest selection of new and used autos in the Pacific Northwest is only a click away at Tonkin.com.
I'll see you later. Facing off once more against Donut Mess With Me. And I'll see you later, getting a taste in that first jam for Late Jammer, grabbing it again.
Donut Mess With Me found a little bit of hole and managed to run past. She's out of the pack.
Back where I come from, we call donut holes munchkins.
Well, Donut Mess With Me got some points on the outside and called off this jam.
We'd like to thank OHSU Sports Medicine, proud to be the official medical care team of the Rose City Rollers. That's OHSU Sports Medicine.
Well, Layla, the Voodoo Dolls came in and were scoreless for the first couple jams, but right now they're at 31 to the Daughters of Doom, 18, with 12 minutes left in this half.
They really knew how to take advantage of those power jams. But Daughters of Doom Jammer Strawberry Short Fuse gonna try and do some damage, but not before Crazy Train out for Lee Jammer.
Crazy!
That's just how it goes.
Crazy Train comes in, she bumps that wall and tries to make a hole. Strawberry Short Fuse finally made it around and she's trying to bust her way through. And out first, Strawberry Short Fuse.
That was really patient and strategic skating by Strawberry Short Fuse. Very methodical to make sure to duck down and not get a little overly zealous with the engagement.
Strawberry Short Fuse trying to find the light of day. She managed to break through that wall with one player left to beat.
Great hit by Freight Train, shutting that path on the outside.
Crazy Train trying to work on the outside, makes it to the inside, gets a bump and calls it off. Picks up 3 points on that pass.
We'd like to thank Bike Punk, locally printed eco-friendly stickers, signs, and design. Visit bikepunk.com.
Wow, look at that. They're all on a pivot line.
For them, it's vintage.
It's retro derby.
It's like totes retro. That's actually how their moms used to play roller derby. They learned it from watching them.
You're going to see Dragon Slayer once again, who had a very good first jam, going up against Ferocious. Dragon Slayer out first as your lead jammer.
All right, everybody sounds good.
Only about a half track separating these two jammers. Both teams of blockers batten down the hatches.
We'd like to thank a new Belgian brewing company with Fat Tire Ale or Ranger IPA. Grab one from the concession stand today.
I'll see you later. Where's the star for the Daughters of Doom?
And Uniscorn.
Going up against Uniscorn for the Voodoo Dolls.
Looks like a full pack out there, 4-on-4. See You Later runs right around turn number one, and she's your lead jammer.
Beautiful recycling up front by the Daughters of Doom.
Oh, and a penalty. That's a forearm call on Uniscorn. Elsie later, she breaks through, picks up a full 5 points on that pass. And right now it's only a 6-point game separating these teams, and the Daughters of Doom have a power jam.
Nice offense coming from Wheel Savage, cracking open just a little bit on that inside line, letting Elsie later do the rest of the work.
Wow, Uniscorn, great lateral move. And she's through the pack on her initial pass.
Uniscorn having some great fortune on that track, going unopposed as jammer.
Frighttown with a big hit on that inside line, taking out the jammer and making her go way back. And that was another great hit by A-Bomb on the outside line, taking out See You Later, but she came back in and even the score as she's trying to power her way through. Wow, there was another fantastic lateral move by LCU later to capitalize on a hole. And we've got about 11 points separating these two teams.
Hey y'all, just so you know, we've got 2017 season passes on sale. We've got special pricing through Christmas Day. See the program for more details. Check them out at rosecityrollers.com.
Okay, Do not good. Mess with me. Where's the star for the Voodoo Dolls? Going up against Gloom and Doom for the Daughters of Doom.
Oh, Gloom and Doom. Oh, she made it out, and she's your lead jammer.
I pretty much stayed the same level. I'm not.
That is a great first attempt at jamming so far this evening by Gloom and Doom. Grabbing that lead jammer status right quick.
Do not mess with me. Getting knocked out on the outside line. She came back in, and she's got all four of those blockers to contend with.
And a penalty purge. We've got most skaters back in action.
And it's a 1-point game now with that last pass. Daughters of Doom just a single point away from taking the lead. Gloom and Doom doing some fancy work, picks up 4 points, and that's a lead chain.
That was a great attempt at offense from Smash Tag, but a little bit overzealous, landed in a back block, called to the penalty box.
Wow.
Don't Mess With Me makes it out on her first initial scoring pass, picking up a full 4 points.
Huge hit coming from Strawberry Short Fuse. Just when Donut Mess With Me thought there was a light at the outside of the tunnel.
And just like that, Donut Mess With Me picking up 8 points so far in this jam, bringing the lead for them now back up to 62. This jam comes to an end. 2 more points picked up for the Voodoo Dolls. 3 points picked up for the Daughters of Doom. And it's a 4-point game.
We'd like to thank Kind Bars, a brand of all natural whole nut and fruit bars made from ingredients you can see and pronounce. That's Kind Bars.
They're kinda tasty.
Oh, they're more than just kinda tasty.
Yeah.
crazy trains wearing the Star 4 Voodoo Dolls. Gonna be going up against Ferocious once we get back to the action on the track.
And there's nobody in the penalty box, so we've got all four blockers from both teams out on the track. Yep, they're having an official timeout. So, Mouth, what do you got?
This official timeout brought to you by Poor Kano. Amazing tacos with two locations on Mississippi and Hawthorne. That's Poor Kano.
Poor K, yes.
Don't deny us.
You know, while they're figuring out all the numbers down on the track, I want to remind everybody, we've got a raffle basket. That raffle basket is valued over $400, it says right here, which includes winter hot tickets, assorted Bettles merch, spoons and jams, Target gift cards, Starbucks gift cards. If you wanted some good stuff, this is your opportunity. You can get those tickets for $1 a piece, 10 for $5, or your height for $20. So buy your raffle tickets and get in that raffle.
Give me that basket. It's full of goodies.
It's full of goodies.
And we're back. Super close game, less than 5 minutes on the countdown. Crazy train for Voodoo Dolls. Ferocious for Daughters of Doom.
Oh, and a nice hit out there on the outside. And number 62 did pick up a penalty for that. That's a Mara Can Gangster.
And it was a back block that sent Ferocious to the Pabst Blue Ribbon penalty box.
That's a half a six pack right now sitting in that Pabst Blue Ribbon penalty box for him.
Of Mountain Dew. Or maybe some root beer.
Could it be Blue Powerade? Yeah, it's all blue.
Blue raspberry flavor. Crazy Train, meanwhile, racking up points for the Voodoo Dolls. Lane Jammer and Power Jammer.
And just like that, that's another 5 points. And Ferocious comes out very quick. Oh, she eked by on that outside line, stayed in bounds, round to the end, and she's out on her initial pass.
Great communication coming from Voodoo Dolls blockers fighting to stay together.
We'd like to thank Radio Cab, the other way to roll. Call a cab today.
Layla, I want to say this again. I am so impressed with the Pedals gameplay right now. They have really escalated their games over the last year or so, and they're showing all this futuristic promise. LCU later is a fine example. She jumps out. She's your lead jammer.
You know, I really like to watch these homegrown Portland skaters. It just feels like such a privilege getting to watch them kind of learn to get their skates under them to now where we see them. I mean, really, the word that comes to mind is tenacity.
Yes.
Because, you know, it's a term that's thrown around a lot, but we really are watching the future of roller derby. And you get to say that you saw LCU later when, you know, because someday we're looking at Team USA players right here.
Yes, we are. That's Gloom and Doom out on the track, going up against Little Trickster. Little Trickster getting taken out on the outside line and picks up a penalty. That's going to be a power jam for the Daughters of Doom.
Gloom and Doom is a real closer for the Daughters of Doom. Second time on the track, second time lead jammer, second time just picking up fistful of points like it ain't no thing.
Yep, tiptoeing along that inside line. Oh, and a penalty call. That's a cut track.
That means this jam is going to go for the full time. Minute and 10 seconds counting down in this jam.
Oh, and just like that, Little Trickster picks up a forearm penalty. She will now switch out and head back to the Pabst Blue Ribbon penalty box. Gloom and Doom comes in and picks up right where she left off, picking up a full 5 points.
You brush that dust off your shoulder.
Ooh, nice move by Little Trickster, jumping through that inside line.
That was some great quick foot speed pickup.
Well, there was a penalty hit there. It came in very, very hot, and we have a skater down. We're gonna check her out, and we'll be back in just a few minutes. Well, that's always a good sign when everybody gets up and skates away. Probably just got the wind knocked out of her, but they're gonna take a quick look at her and make sure she's just is doing as well as she could be. Now, Layla, with our wonderful age that we've reached, we probably would not bounce as well as they do.
I've got no cartilage left between my bones. And for them, they're mostly cartilage and no bones.
Yeah,
so
they can take a hit a lot better than we can.
Oh, yeah. You can play jacks with most of these skaters out here. They're going to bounce higher than those bouncy balls.
Well, it is a 4-point difference. Right now, the Voodoo Dolls holding on ever so tightly to a 4-point lead, but they are in a power jam with those 4 points separating these two teams.
Do not mess with me. Momentarily going unopposed, weaving around those last line defenders. Beautiful recycling by Daughters of Doom blockers.
Yeah, that was a fantastic hit by Ferocious, sticking with the jammer and not letting her get off of that outside line. Excellent defense by the Daughters of Doom. They are basically shutting down that power jam and doing a really good job of it.
Screamsicle trying to catch a little piece of offense.
Oh, and that is another penalty being picked up for the Daughters of Doom.
Lots of chatting coming down from that track. Daughters of Doom blockers doing a great job trying to separate jammer and pivot. Now, what you just witnessed, if you're new to us tonight, is a star pass. What that means is the pivot, the skater that had the stripe on their helmet, is now in a position to receive the star and now will start collecting points.
But she cannot call off the jam. And yeah, all she can do is score.
That's correct. That's a pretty important power to have, but yes, you do not get to pass the status as well.
Nice work out there by Gloom and Doom. Willed her way through that pack, and she's now on her initial scoring pass. Two blockers left to beat out there. She glides along the inside and picks up 4 points. It's a hypothetical tied game as we roll into intermission. Nope, I always talk too soon, don't I?
All righty, we are just about getting back to the game. Only 3 points separating these two teams. Voodoo Dolls sitting pretty with 81. Two Daughters of Doom, 78. Couple quick stats from the first half. Top scorers of the Daughters of Doom included I'll See You Later, who scored 29 points in that first half. Also, 4-for-4 in Lee Jammer when hitting that line. Gloom and Doom, top scorer for the Daughters of Doom with 31 points so far in that first half. And for the Voodoo Dolls, 31 points for Uniscorn. That is the top scorer for that team. And Crazy Train, 21 points put up for the Voodoo Dolls. Getting back to the line, we have Ferocious wearing the star for the Daughters of Doom.
And she's going to be in a power jam as Screamsicle is going to be sitting pretty in the Pabst Blue Ribbon penalty box. This jam is underway, and just like that, Ferocious is out first.
Daughters of Doom did have a slight blocker advantage that Ferocious loved taking advantage of.
That was fantastic offense being laid down out there. That was Frighttown giving a little bump and opening up some holes.
Frighttown has really asserted herself on the track tonight as both a very important defensive and offensive blocker.
Ferocious around the outside, picking up another 5 points.
Screamsicles back in action, eking out the initial pass.
Daughters of Doom have not only taken the lead, they are really pushing the score out. This jam comes to an end, and we got a score of 92-81. Daughters of Doom are in the lead.
We'd like to thank Franz Bakery. Franz has been proudly baking in Portland since 1906. Thanks, Franz.
Smash Tag's gonna try her hand at jamming for the Daughters of Doom, going up against seasoned Petals veteran, Dragon Slayer.
And around the outside, Smash Tag! Daughters of Doom right now really getting themselves in a good position for scoring. Wow, she glided through backwards, made it look easy, picking up 4 points off that inside line.
It was so smooth, you almost couldn't even feel it.
We'd like to thank Voodoo Donut. The magic is indeed in the hole. Proud sponsor of the Rose City Rollers and the Wheels of Justice. Thanks, Voodoo.
Uniscorn wears the star for Voodoo Dolls, going up against I'll See You Later for the Daughters.
I'll See You Later, making it true. She's out first again as your lead jammer.
Charging right through the middle, too. Doing so cleanly. That is some powerhouse jamming.
Well, she gets bumped out of bounds, but the blocker followed her right out. That means she could come right back in and pick up 5 points on that pass. Well, everybody's on the ground up at the top of the apex. And I'll See You Later calls it off.
That was incredible footwork and speed control by Uniscorn. I don't think anyone saw that coming. So subtle, really quick, great adjustment to pick up 4 points in those last seconds of the jam.
We'd like to thank Car2Go. Meet the future of car sharing. Sign up today at car2go.com.
Wearing the star and the C for Voodoo, Donut Mess With Me. She's ready for her sponsorship.
Well, Donut Mess With Me picks up a back block, so she's headed to the Pabst Blue Ribbon penalty box, and right along with her is Ferocious. It's a star-spangled penalty box over there.
Blue ribbons and stars fill that penalty box, but as the new rules dictate, because both jammers went to the penalty box at the same time, they were released at exactly the same time. There will be no more 10-second blocker showcases.
And another penalty being picked up. Four, 5 points being picked up, and Daughters of Doom right now pushing their score up even further.
And the path of least resistance was the inside line.
It's like a forearm call, and that's going to be going against Ferocious and giving the Voodoo Dolls a power jam.
This is a great opportunity for Voodoo Dolls to reclaim the lead. There are only 15 points separating the Daughters of Doom, who started this second half so strong.
And another penalty being called on Donut Mess With Me. She will be heading to the penalty box.
A veritable baton pass amongst the jammers, as Ferocious is back in action.
Way to work those corners. That was great footwork out there to get through that pack.
We'd like to thank PDX Pipeline, your online source for Portland's music, arts, and events happenings. That's PDX Pipeline.
Smash tag, where's the star once more for the Daughters of Doom? Going unopposed. But it looks like an official review as the folks in stripes cross their T's and dot their I's.
This official timeout brought to you again by Poor K. No. Amazing tacos with two locations on Mississippi and Hawthorne. That's Poor K. No.
Poor K. Yes. All right. Well, we've got 14 minutes left in this first bout of the evening. Daughters of Doom fans, please show yourselves. All right, that was pretty good. What about Voodoo Dolls, friends, families, and fiends? That's awesome. I'm so glad y'all are here tonight.
Looks like Smash Tag down there on the line, and it's gonna be a power jam. Here comes the O, and Smash Tag making it look easy, but really, it was her team down there.
American Gangster, huge offense.
Here comes the O again. Bodies are on the floor, and a forearm call. Yeah, she came through kind of swinging those wings a little bit.
Coming in hot.
She was smashing some tag, you might say. Don't know.
Too much Mountain Dew for you this evening.
It happens.
You are cut off.
Yep. Smash Tag once again served her time. She's on the track and picks up 5 points very quickly.
Daughters of Doom got a taste for the lead, and they do not want to let it up.
And there, another 4 points on that pass. Oh.
Forearm penalty being called against American Gangster.
Another 5 points being picked up on. That's 14 points so far for Smash Tag.
We did have a star pass by the Voodoo Dolls. Donut Mess With Me passing the star to Screamsicle.
Very, very quickly through the pack. 4 more points being picked up for the Voodoo Dolls.
This is the biggest jam we've seen so far of the evening. Still with just under 10 seconds left of it.
Shruganap, hit after hip, Screamsicle picking up another 4 points on that pass. But really, the story of that last jam was the Daughters of Doom in Smash Tag picking up a grand total of 26 points. Dang, Layla SmackDown, 26 points.
I need to take a nap just from watching that last jam. It's past my bedtime.
It's not even 7 o'clock yet.
All this visual action just wore her out. All right, on the land, that's Dragon Slayer for the Voodoo Dolls going up against Strawberry Short Fuse.
Dragon Slayer whipping around that outside for Lead Jammer.
She came around that track picking up speed and now has engaged that wall and got knocked out of bounds. Strawberry Short Fuse doing a nice job getting out of the pack.
Great defense by Daughters of Doom blockers.
The sham comes to an end, but not before 3 points gets picked up.
Not sure if you've heard, but Rose City Rollers, we are participating in a sock drive to benefit Outside In Trans Clinic. We've got a box set up by the behind the bleachers closest to the stairs up here to the mezzanine. If you're here tomorrow, please bring some donations of socks to drop off. It would be greatly appreciated.
Little Trickster out there going up against Ferocious.
Little Trickster charging down the middle, but great job by Smash Tag racing out. Last line's offense, and Ferocious taking advantage of that forward lead jammer.
Little Trickster trying to get on that inside line and gets knocked down out of bounds.
Wow, Smash Tag, another great last hit. Really the quintessential blocker jammer pivots extraordinaire.
A-Bomb giving a little love tap as she was calling off that jam.
We'd like to thank Oaks Amusement Park, home of the Rose City Rollers and the place to purchase your derby gear. That's Oaks Amusement Park.
Penalty box is empty. All four blockers from both teams are out on the track. And it looks like LCU Later is down there with a star on her helmet up against Uniscorn.
Great self-assist around that outside. LCU Later is out for Lee Jammer.
LCU Later gliding around the outside once again. She likes that outside line, doesn't she?
Stick with what works.
Remember to include Rose City Rollers on your holiday list this year with a tax-deductible donation to your favorite nonprofit on wheels. Details at rosecityrollers.com. Also, check out the give guide.
Well, a timeout being called on the track. Voodoo Dolls want to figure out what they can do. Daughters of Doom have come out after halftime on an absolute tear. They have picked up a number of points, and right now they're in the lead, 152-106.
Yes, 60 points, over 60 points put up by the Daughters of Doom in the second half. Voodoo Dolls putting up just about 25 points. Smash Tag swapping out accessories. This round, wearing the star. Going up against the Dragon Slayer.
Dragon Slayer goes in. She finds an opening right there as a pile of bodies in turn number one. And Dragon Slayer is your lead jammer.
Unbelievable maneuvering, foot speed, control, and just for style points, how about a little bunny hop for you?
I just want to say wow one more time. Multiplayer block. Dragon Slayer is through, and she is in a power jam.
Huge opportunity for the Voodoo Dolls right now. Great defense by the Daughters of Doom. But Dragon Slayer gets up the foot speed, works the way around, another 5 points picked up in that pass.
Yeah, that was some great defense. She got knocked out of bounds, stood right back up, collected herself, and jumped right in to get out and pick up those points.
Dragon Slayer is one of the best people in this league at pick up foot speed. From a near standstill to, you know, 0 to 60 in no time at all.
Well, she just missed her Mr. Q there. She was trying to glide around that outside, but she's right back up in it.
Well, don't worry. She'll take the inside this round.
And with that, another 4 points being picked up. And that's how you get back in the game. That's a 23-point jam for Dragon Slayer.
We'd like to thank Buffalo Gap Saloon and Eatery, John's Landing's favorite eatery and saloon. That's Buffalo Gap Saloon and Eatery.
Crazy train wearing the star for the Voodoo Dolls.
Crazy.
That's how she goes. Up against Ferocious for the Daughters of Doom.
And speaking of Ferocious, she's out first as your lead jammer. Crazy Crane getting dropped by Strawberry Short Fuse in turn number two.
We'd like to thank Echo Construction here in the house tonight. The friendly people at Echo Construction love custom home building, remodels, and of course, a roller derby. Thanks, Echo.
And you know we love to see skaters getting up and skating off the track. But getting back to the track, Gloom and Doom's gonna wear the star once more for the Daughters of Doom. Going up against Do Not Mess With Me for the Voodoo Dolls.
Well, there's gonna be a slight pack advantage as two of the blockers for the Daughters of Doom are, say, in the Pabst Blue Ribbon penalty box, which will give a good opportunity for the Voodoo Dolls to once again get lead jam with that less defense.
All right. We're just going to do a little check-in. And we are in a timeout.
No.
This looks like an official review.
Okay.
An official timeout. Getting all of our ducks and skaters and points and penalties in a row.
Well, I got to make sure that everything adds up.
Yeah. Special K serial killer wears the star for the daughters, going up against Dragon Slayer for Voodoo.
And I think that's the first time we've seen her on the Jammer line with that star.
It is, it is.
But someone we've talked about quite a bit, Dragon Slayer, she's out first and is your lead jammer.
Special K's got her in her sights, though.
Wow.
Beautiful charge through that middle of the wall. Special K picking up 4 points on that pass.
She must have been eating her Special K.
Clearly.
Oh, we'd like to thank Black Cat Plumbing, your local neighborhood plumbing company and a proud part of Rose City Rollers since 2009. That's Black Cat Plumbing.
40 points now separate these teams. 5 minutes left in this game. This jam is on with Uniscorn and Fright Town as your jammers.
Fright Town charges right down the middle. Lead jammer.
Wow, LCU later. Very heads up play, trying to take her back. Made her go way back to turn number one to start again. Both jammers now out of the pack. All four blockers in turn number four, and they're setting up and getting ready.
Great speed control by Fright Town, making sure not to come in too hot. Managed to pick up a handful of points in the process. 8 points put up in that jam for the daughters.
We'd like to thank Prana Portland Clothing for people who live fully, play long, and travel well. That's Prana Portland. I'd also like to thank Secret Aardvark. Viva la Aardvark.
Viva la Aardvark.
And another official review brought to you by Poor K. No. Not an official review, an official timeout brought to you by Poor K. No. Amazing tacos with 2 locations on Mississippi and Hawthorne.
Poor K. Yes. Well, you know, I might not have checked earlier, but where are all my Daughters of Doom fans out there? Where are you guys at? And what about the Voodoo Dolls? Where are those fans at?
All right, getting back to it. Smash Tag, where's the star for the daughters? Going up against Donut Mess With Me for the Voodoo Dolls.
Smash Tag Jammer. Excellent defense being played by the Daughters of Doom. They've tightened it up.
Beautiful juke and fake by Donut Mess With Me, shaking those last lines of defenders.
Just like that, they're calling it off after picking up 4 points. That's how you do it. Get in there, make some action, and call that down.
We'd like to thank Laurelhurst Theater and Pub, the best of modern cinema, independent art, and classic film for Portland's movie lovers. That's Laurelhurst Theater and Pub.
With just over 3 minutes of gameplay in this first bout of the evening, hopefully all of you derby noobs out there have finally gotten it dialed in.
Strawberry Short Fuse taking that inside, and she's out of the pack as your lead jammer.
Once again, I'm really into Short Fuse's patient and calm strategic footwork. Very clean, very focused.
Oh, there was a star pass, and just like that, number 21 jumped up, knocked her out of bounds. That was Fright Town saying, nope, you go out of bounds.
No, really, after you. I insist.
Strawberry Short Fuse running right around all the red shirts, picking up her points and continuing on with this lead push that the Daughters of Doom have done since intermission. Inside line was wide open. Strawberry Short Fuse says, yes, I will take those points, thank you.
Well, and you're very welcome. Checking in with the bench, Coach Hetty signaling to call that jam dead. 19 points picked up in that pass.
We'd like to thank Socket To Me. Unleash your inner superhero at SocketToMe.com.
And a little bit of Tiffany's gonna play us out into the final minutes of this bout. Ferocious, where's the star for the Daughters, up against Dragon Slayer for the Voodoo Dolls, and it's Dragon Slayer, lead jammer.
Ferocious hot on her wheels, and they're setting up defense, getting ready to go. Excellent job by Dragon Slayer, picking up some points. Oh, and a hit call being called on Ferocious. And that's going to give a power jam to Dragon Slayer.
Music to Dragon Slayer's ears.
Yep, she thinks she's alone now.
There doesn't seem to be anyone around. Except for those fierce Daughters of Doom dropping hits. Like Galileo dropped the orange.
Yes. Yes.
Dragon Slayer taking a big hit. Oh, but does get taken out of bounds.
Now everyone sit tight.
Well, I think
we do have a team timeout that looks like it's being honored, called by the Voodoo Dolls bench. We're going to check it and see, because there is a chance one more jam. So please do stay off the track until you see the official final score up. Thank you so much for your patience and understanding.
Well, that's an opportunity right there with 1 second left on the clock. Their score right now is at 205, 149. Daughters of Doom are well in the lead.
Nice, we are gonna get to go one more jam.
Well, they might have missed there was a skater in the penalty box for the Daughters of or Voodoo Dolls. That's going to make a slight pack advantage for the Daughters of Doom.
Gloom and Doom, where's the star for the Daughters of Doom? Going up against Sassafras for the Voodoo Dolls.
Sassafras, first time on the line. Sassafras out for, oh, and a penalty being called. Sassafras was all ready to go. And she picked up a little bonus call there. Didn't quite hear the ref.
It's noisy in here. I can understand.
That sometimes happens.
You get focused. You get fixated.
Gloom and Doom is your lead jammer. She calls it off. And ladies and gentlemen, we have an unofficial score as we send it down. Now, don't forget, we'll be doing MVPs after this game has a final score at the victory laps.
All right, well, it looks like the Daughters of Doom have gone ahead and selected who their MVP choices will be.
All right, who is your MVP blocker?
Unicorn. Unicorn.
Unicorn. And who do we have for MVP jammer?
Dragon Slayer.
Dragon Slayer.
All right, Voodoo Dolls, who are your reps? Excellent. Who have you selected for MVP block? Jammer, you want to pick Jammer first? Let's do Jammer. Who have you picked for Jammer?
Gloom and Doom.
Gloom and Doom, come on down. All right, and who have we picked for MVP blocker?
We have Fright Town.
Fright Town, come on down. All right, let's get you guys coming out. Let's take a picture. MVPs, come on out, take a picture.
Well,
yes,
we do have.
You earned it.
Also, one last thing we would like to announce. One of our veteran skaters, Crazy Train, is chugging on down the tracks, and tonight is her final bout as a rose petal. We'd like to wish her all the luck with her new team, the Rock City Rollers in the Netherlands. They're lucky to have you, and you will be missed. Once again, thank you very much, Crazy Train.
Okay, we need both teams right here in the middle really quick so we can get photos and then move on to the next bout. So everyone, snug it up. Snug it up.
How you doing?
Pretty good.
Getting it all down? You understand what's up?
Yeah, I understand.
All right, and as you can see from the countdown clock, we have under 15 minutes before we get to the next bout of the evening. Plenty of time for you to go grab some merch, grab some raffle tickets, grab some drinks, grab some food. Do what you gotta do, powder your nose, get it all done. We will see you back here in just a few minutes. Okay.